my channel. Hit the bell icon.
Welcome to one more session of the excretory system. Today we are going to learn about the structure of nephron. Nephron is a structural and functional unit of excretory system. So each kidney contains approximately 1 million nephrons. So these nephrons are arranged in the cortical region of the kidney. So each nephron is divided into two parts, that is Malpighian body and the renal tubule. So this is the Malpighian body and this is the renal tubule structure. So Malpighian body consists of two parts, Bowman's capsule and glomerulus. So the red one is a glomerulus. This blue one cup-like structure is known as Bowman's capsule. So Bowman's capsule is a cup-like structure and it is first described by scientist William Bowman. That's why the name Bowman's capsule. So this Bowman's capsule consists of two layers, the outer and the inner layer. Outer layer is known as parietal layer and the inner layer is known as visceral layer. So the inner layer consists of a special type of cells known as podocytes. So these cells contain food processes, food. So that's why the name podocytes. So these cells are arranged in an intricate manner and leave a small spaces which are known as filtration pores. The podocytes surrounds the capillaries of the glomerulus. So glomerulus is formed by two arterioles, afferent arteriole, which is a branch of renal artery. So this afferent arteriole enters into the glomerulus and divided into numerous capillaries and they unite and form a efferent renal arteriole. See the difference of the diameter. Afferent renal arteriole diameter is more when compared to the efferent renal arteriole. So this creates the pressure in the glomerulus for the filtration. The endothelial cells of the capillaries which are present in the glomerulus contains pores which are known as fenestration pores. So these fenestration pores of the capillaries and the podocytes, slit pores, are useful for the ultrafiltration in the glomerulus part. So we will discuss it in the formation of urine in detail. Okay, so this is the Bowman's capsule. So the renal tubule blind end, this is the renal tubule, this is the renal tubule structure. The blind end of the renal tubule is modified into a cup-like structure, that is the Bowman's capsule. So the Bowman's capsule leads into a convoluted, highly coiled tubular structure which is known as proximal convoluted tubule. Whenever convoluted comes, you remember it is a coiled structure. So why this is coiled? Because the space is very less, as the number of nephrons are million, the space for them is little. That's why the tubes become highly coiled, so they can be adjusted in the small area. So next, the proximal convoluted, the inner border of the inner lining of PCT, this is also known as PCT, contains brush border cells. So the brush border also increases the area of absorption. So the PCT continues as a U-shaped structure. This is a U-shaped structure. This is known as Henle's loop or loop of Henle. So Henle's loop contains two limbs, the descending limb. So the limb which is going down is known as descending limb, and the limb that is going up is known as ascending limb. So here you observe the diameter of ascending limb is varied. So the proximal part of the ascending limb is thin when compared to the distal part, that is a thick. So this is useful for the filtration process. Next, the ascending limb continues as another convoluted tubule, which is known as distal convoluted tubule or DCT. This distal convoluted tubule opens, continues as a initial collecting duct. Initial collecting duct. So, the initial collecting ducts of the nearby nephrons unite and form a common straight duct, which is known as straight collecting duct. So, this is the straight collecting duct. This straight collecting duct passes through the medulla and opens through renal papilla into renal pelvis. So all the straight collecting ducts in the renal pyramid unite to form a common duct, which is known as duct of Bellini. And this duct of Bellini opens into renal papilla, through the renal papilla into renal pelvis through calyx. So that's why the urine which is formed in the nephron is poured into the renal pelvis. So this is about the structure of a nephron. So the efferent renal arteriole, which comes out from the glomerulus, forms a network of capillaries. So the red structure here is a network of capillaries, which is known as peritubular capillaries. So the peritubular capillaries, which surrounds the Henle's loop. So this is the Henle loop and these are the peritubular capillaries. So the peritubular capillaries which surrounds the Henle's loop is known as vasa recta. Vasa recta is absent or poorly developed in cortical nephrons and highly developed in juxtamedullary nephrons. Depending upon the length of the Henle's loop, nephrons are divided into two types, cortical nephrons and juxtamedullary nephrons. Cortical nephrons, so the Henle's loop is small and it is penetrated into the medullary region, only the peripheral region of the medulla. But juxtamedullary nephrons, the Henle's loop is very long and it is penetrated deeply into the medulla. So such type of nephrons are known as juxtamedullary nephrons. So this vasa recta is also different in these nephrons. In cortical nephrons, it is poorly developed or absent. But in juxtamedullary nephrons, vasa recta is well developed. So in examination point of view, you have to remember why it is so. So I will discuss it in the urine formation, why the vasa recta is useful and it is well developed in juxtamedullary nephrons.